into Tatum. Tatum falls down, throws it ahead, Schroeder. Schroeder to Smart, three-pointer, bang! Bang, he ties the game at the buzzer!
Evan Fournier inexplicably doubled Tatum, which set upon the chain.
Well, congratulations to Marcus Smart. He recently got married. He's had himself a heck of an offseason. Outside of his marriage, Marcus was traded from the team that drafted him, the Boston Celtics, to the Memphis Grizzlies, and which he'll now pair with Jaren Jackson. We now got the reigning two Defensive Player of the Years on the same squad. After Jaylen Brown posted picture with his guy, Marcus Smart, on his day, Jaylen said, "My brother for life." How about Jaren Jackson trolling Jaylen? And he said, "He's my brother now." Uh-oh, I like that smoke there, Jaren. And I like Jaylen Brown giving me a little smoke back to Jaren Jackson. He said, "Cap to Jaren, he don't even mess with y'all." Obviously, this is problematic because Jaren Jackson ain't played a game with Marcus yet. And obviously, Jaylen Brown and Marcus have pretty much played their entire careers together. So it's kind of like, if I'm Jaren Jackson, like, what do you know? Are you speaking for Marcus Smart? Or are you just trolling me back because I trolled you? Is there a world where Marcus Smart told Jaylen Brown, "I really don't want to be a part of the Memphis Grizzlies"? I hope that's not the case. Y'all know I'm from Memphis, though I am a diehard Lakers fan. I am from Memphis, and I want to see my home squad Grizzlies do well. I'm just thinking to myself, man, if Marcus is all in on being on a part of that Memphis Grizzlies culture, you are talking about probably one of the best, hardest working defenses in quite some time once Ja Morant comes back from suspension. I mean, this is a team in this modern day of basketball where teams are averaging 108, 110 points a game. There's a world where the Grizzlies could hold teams to around 87 to 93 points a game. That sounds crazy, right? But yeah, I do believe there is a world where Memphis can stifle teams, you know, in the late 80s, top of the 90s. And, you know, and it's a lot of their games. They already want to slow it down, you know, when it's late in games. Obviously, Memphis wants to run and blow you out as much as possible. But late in games, they've been one of the worst fourth quarter teams over the last couple years. They slow it down a lot, right? So you're talking about games that are going to get in the 80s and 90s. Hopefully, Steven Adams comes back ready to ball. You know, you got bangers on Memphis. Again, like I said, Jaren Jackson, reigning Defensive Player of the Year. If he gets another one, he's going to be eligible for a lot of money. Marcus won it the year before that. These are two guys that can defend at exceptional levels, one on the perimeter, one down low. This Grizzly squad, man, if Marcus is invested, hopefully Jaylen's role, they can be very, very tough to beat. And I would love to see a Memphis-Boston Finals. I'm just calling a spade. I think that would be quite the show. I think that could be the start of something special. A lot of young stars on both sides. Ironically, you could argue that Jason Tatum and Ja Morant are the two best American-born stars in the NBA. So obviously, from a marketing perspective, that's gold. Wasn't it the Boston Celtics that Ja Morant said last year, "I'm not worried about nobody in the West, but I am worried about Boston"? That's who I'm looking at. He said, "We good in the West, right?" And then everything kind of went to hell for Memphis. So yes, hopefully there's something here to this rivalry between Jaylen Brown and Jaren Jackson as they troll each other on social media.
I want to salute you, homie, you know, for building your own thing and doing your own thing.
Why build theirs when I believe I can build my own?
You've already done it, or I wouldn't be here.
I'm already the only elite sports and music journalist in the game today. My goal is simple: to be the best there's ever been. So
please don't go.
Make sure you subscribe and follow the journey. It truly means everything to me. I tell stories, I talk music, I cover sports, I am culture, I am Ferro.